Hello students, in this video I'll be discussing about the application of the Green's theorem in a plane. To begin with, let us evaluate a line integral using Green's theorem given C is the boundary of the triangle enclosed by y equal to 0, x equal to pi by 2, y equal to 2x by pi. Now, according to Green's theorem, integral C mdx plus ndy is double integral over R dou n by dou x minus dou m by dou y dx dy. M and n are continuous functions, and so will the partial derivatives. Now m equal to y minus sin x, so dou m by dou y is 1. N equal to cos x, so dou n by dou x will be minus sin x. So integral C mdx plus ndy is double integral over R minus sin x minus 1 dx dy. Now to identify the limits, we need to draw the region. Now we have y equal to 0, then x equal to pi by 2. So let me take this as 0 comma 0. Next is x equal to pi by 2. So let me take this to be pi by 2. So this will form pi by 2 comma 0. So this is the line x equal to pi by 2. Now y equal to 2x by pi. When x equal to 0, we have 0 comma 0. That means it passes through the origin. So y equal to 2x by pi passes through 0, 0. And when x equal to pi by 2, this implies y equal to 1. So we'll take this pi by 2 comma 1 as the point and join them. So we have this triangle. So the limits for R is y equal to 0 to y equal to 2x by pi, x equal to 0 to x equal to pi by 2. So integral, so for convenience let us call this as I. We'll call this as I. So I equal to minus integral 0 to pi by 2, 0 to 2x by pi sin x plus 1 dy dx, because The inner limit is for y. Variable limits always inside. Therefore, limits for y. So dy first. So this will give us minus integral 0 to pi by 2 sine x plus 1 into y. The limit is 0 to 2x by pi dx. So I equal to minus integral 0 to pi by 2 sine x plus 1 into 2x by pi dx, which is minus 2 by pi integral 0 to pi by 2 x sine x plus x dx. Now the first term we have to apply integration by parts. So we get x into minus cos x minus 1 into minus sin x. So this would be the result of integration by parts, plus x squared by 2 from 0 to pi by 2. So this will be minus 2 by pi into, when x is pi by 2, we get pi by 2 into cos pi by 2, that is 0, minus when x is 0, we get 0 cos 0 plus sin pi by 2 minus sin 0 plus, here we get pi squared by 4 divided by 2 minus 0. So this simplifies to minus 2 by pi into 1 plus pi squared by 8. We consider another application of the Green's theorem. Show that 1 by 2 integral c x dy minus y dx is the area of the region enclosed by simple closed curve C. And hence, find the area of the ellipse x squared by a squared plus y squared by b squared equal to 1. Now we have I equal to 1 by 2 integral c x dy minus y dx. This we can rewrite it as integral c minus y by 2 dx plus x by 2 dy. So that we have it in the standard form that we write the Green's theorem. Now according to Green's theorem, integral c mdx plus ndy equal to double integral over r dou n by dou x minus dou m by dou y dx dy. So m is minus y by 2. So dou m by dou y is minus 1 by 2. N is x by 2. So dou n by dou x is 1 by 2. So integral c minus y by 2 dx plus x by 2 dy. This is double integral over r 1 by 2 minus 1 by 2 dx dy, which simplifies to double integral over r dx dy. Now, by definition of the double integrals, this is the area of region R. Therefore, integral 1 by 2 integral x dy minus y dx represents area of region R bounded by C. So we have proved the result that the given line integral represents the area of the region enclosed by the curve C. Now to evaluate the area of ellipse using the line integral, to that end, we have area equal to 1 by 2 integral C x dy minus y dx. To evaluate the line integral, it is ideal for us to convert the line integral as a simple integral with a single variable. Now, since we have a closed curve, it would be appropriate for us to use parametric form. So we take x equal to a cos t, y equal to a sin t. Now to get the b sin t, so to get the complete closed curve, the t should vary from 0 to 2 pi. Now t is a parameter and not necessarily the angle made by the line joining the point with the origin. T is a parameter. So dx will be minus a sin t dt, and dy will be b cos t dt. So area equal to 1 by 2 integral t is from 0 to 2 pi, x is a cos t, dy is b cos t minus y is b sin t, dx is minus a sin t dt, which is AB by 2 integral 0 to 2 pi cos square t plus sin square t dt, which is AB by 2 integral 0 to 2 pi dt. This is AB by 2 t from 0 to 2 pi. So we get area of the ellipse to be AB by 2 into 2 pi, which is pi AB.